Opportunities for AI as treatment, corset treatment. Good morning, everybody. I represent Belarus, our Republican Center for Traumatology and Orthopedy from the city of Minsk. Usually, all traditional meetings dedicated to deformities of the spine go from conservative to surgical treatment. Today's agenda is formed differently. First, we listen to some very interesting research materials by Professor Dudin, and then this powerful presentation on surgical technologies. The fact is that we deal, by we here, I mean my colleagues from the Republic of Belarus, we deal with the spine deformities for a long time. And first and foremost, I want to pass great regards from Belarus orthopedists, traumatologists, and prosthetists, with whom together we can work in terms of specialized corrective assistance to the patients. This slide shows you what Belarus is all about. We have 9.3 million population, which means 1.5 St. Petersburgs, or one St. Petersburg with all its suburbs. We practically have a well-organized system of patients control. We do not have to go around the country and in search of the patients or potential patients. Fortunately, we have an opportunity to see such patients. They usually come to us themselves, not with neglected cases. We have some neglected cases, but we manage mainly to detect the deformities at early stages. We mentioned different methods of treatment, and we've been presenting our development for the classification of these methods for idiopathic scoliosis. We have divided all the methods in four groups. Number two is called the leading methods, only three methods. The methods that directly impact the deformity of the spine with corrective or stabilization aims, special physiotherapy, brace treatment, and surgical treatment. The choice of the leading method is strictly based on the definition of the parameters and manifestation of the deformities, nature of development, the growth plasticity of the spine, the concomitant pathology of energy, if any, and the psychological perception by the patient, the recommended corrective treatment, because we are treating a live person, not the X-ray. Usually it's a child or a teenager, and very often it's his or her parents who make the decision. The brace treatment to which my presentation of today is dedicated has a very rich history. It's a many centuries experience. And this brace treatment is a routine classical standard for the corrective treatment of patients with the spinal deformities in cases of idiopathic scoliosis. I've presented many times the results of using brace treatment in St. Petersburg, though I myself am not an expert on conservative treatment. I'm an active surgeon who conducts all these surgical interventions. But look, what are the main objectives of the corset or brace treatment, and why this brace therapy is very special? It should forcibly, not invasively, but forcibly and very actively impact the deformity relief on the surface of the trunk of the specific patient. And hence, the choice of the brace first and foremost, and we have chosen the technology by Jacques Chenon out of the huge arsenal of proposals existent as of today. Why? Because this is a very special concept, a special technique of corrective impact simultaneously in three planes based on the derotating mechanism principles. If in three planes during scoliosis we have deformity, the structure or the support that envisages Chenon brace, it envisages not contraction but derotation. And there are several supports, 2, 5, 6 supports. This is defined by the anatomical type of deformity, which may be different. We have, as of today, the experience of working with patients on the basis of Chenon technique, more than 6,000 children and teenagers, until their bone growth, their spine, or the physiological maturity of the spine is finished. Indications for brace therapy are the deformities with the Bengal in standing position, starting from 20 degrees. This is a parameter when the deformity arch has touched the anatomobiomechanical stability of the spine, and different conservative methods like active physical exercises wouldn't lead to the result that we would like to see. Never mind how well it is being done. As military people say, we need to have some more serious weapons. And the main condition is the compliance with the therapy program. It's not just wearing the brace, and the control, examination, and the orthopedist 2 to 5 times a year, and visits to the prosthetist is the person or the medical doctor who made this brace. The total time of wearing the corset is not 24 hours, because patients need to bathe, to sleep, etc. The minimum is 20 to 25 hours per day, including sleeping, because we have to take into account the growth period, the periods of therapy, adaptation period 2 to 8 weeks, primary correction 2 to 6 months, brace retainment, because there is a question of how long the brace should be worn up to the end of the bone growth, the spine. In AIS patients, the spine matures not earlier than at 16 years. Hence, treatment very often lasts 4 years. Very often, patients may undergo up to 8 braces. Then next stage is the period of cancellation of the brace, which takes from 6 to 12 months. And the follow-up period, we do not eliminate the idiopathic scoliosis. We simply change the scenario of the symptom complex due to application of this technique. The goal of this research was to look at the possibilities of the brace corrective method. We didn't analyze all the 6,000 of patients, but only those who have certain objective dynamics. 976 patients in all, they started therapy at the age of 5-17 years of age. In terms of expression of deformity, grade 2, 11 to 25. 109 patients, third grade 26-40, 450, and fourth grade more than 41, 2017, we did not operate on them immediately. And the age limit is from 5 to 17 years of age, and well, not in their documents, but in terms of their vertebras on the basis of Satofyeva test. Quite a busy table which illustrates that in all the cases at primary adaptation to brace, we managed to reach the decrease of the deformity arch no less than 20%. Some of the patients had hypercorrection, which meant 100 something decrease. Because these are the growing patients, children. In cases of AIS, we do not usually have 100% rigidity. There is functional mobility, which we managed to achieve with the use of the brace. This is X-ray examples of how we achieve primary correction in the course of 4 to 6 months. In two projections and standing position, and at the beginning of the treatment, and then after the primary correction, look at the lower line, 71 degree in 10-year-old boy, and we managed to reach the decrease of the deformity arch 28 degrees, which means that the patient did not say no to the operation, but we decided to try and use his spine's growth plasticity. Not in every case and not always this may be achieved, because this growth plasticity is very, very individual. But we have to examine the patient, follow up and check retainment of the brace, because the cause of deformity, the cause of progression cannot be eliminated neither by physical exercises, nor braces, nor surgical intervention. With the help of the brace, we identify how the scoliotic deformity process will behave. And this table in the at the bottom, it shows here the group of severe, primarily severe deformities, higher than 40 degrees. But we managed to achieve a good stabilization of the primary result in 30% and improvement of additional correction in more than 15% in the process of wearing brace. I do not say that these parameters are better in deformative curvatures, as manifested. The dynamics of the period of brace retainment, we followed it up from 3 to 8, 9 years, and it showed that in the majority of the patients, we managed to achieve the so-called stabilizing effect of wearing brace. When the bone growth of the spine finished, we started the cancellation period, the wearing brace period, and we analyzed 319 patients who finished the wearing the brace, and that's how it may be seen on the X-ray, direct projections in standing positions, frontal view. First issue, X-ray, then the correction achieved, the X-ray prior to cancellation of wearing the brace, and then when the bone growth finished. In the bottom we have the so-called 160 degrees example. The patient, a female, came to us, she was inoperable. She had a concomitant pathology on the side of the cardiovascular system. We had to help her somehow, and we managed to reach 139 degrees in 1 year, 135. She is still wearing the brace, she is 24 now. And during the period of active awakening, she wears the brace. It improves not only the state of the spine, it excludes any pressure on the cardiovascular complex. The brace retainment period allowed us to detect the so-called aggressive malignant forms. The upper line shows us how the deformity from 44 degrees inside the brace for the period of education degrees to 18, and then in the course of years increased again back to 44. This doesn't mean that the praise didn't help. If we didn't use the praise, the progression would have been much higher. If we had operated the progression, I may assure you, might have shown itself at post-op period. Because the patient continued to grow and develop very actively. The bottom line, the second line shows 25 degrees of the initial deformity arch. With brace, we receive zero, which means 100% frontal correction. Then she enters puberty, first menstruation, and a very aggressive demonstration of the increase of deformity, very gradual, very slow. By 16, 17 years of age, wearing the position, she has 57 degrees. The question is, did the brace help? No, it did. Because when we cancel the brace, we received 71 degrees immediately. So the question was, when did we have to use the surgical intervention? At 41 degrees in 14 years of age, or later in 57 degrees,
we operated
at 71 degrees and came to 18 degrees after the operation when the girl was already 18. The efficacy of the brace therapy conducted, very busy table, I'm not going to go into detail. Just a few
things.
Out of 319 patients, in 157 cases, which means almost 50%, we have achieved a well-manifested correction of the deformity with the stabilization of the cases. Last example shows 41 degrees lower line of x-rays. With brace, we came to good correction in the course of 4 years. The patient wore the course of brace. After stopping wearing the brace, one notch remains 9 degrees, the other one at 0 degrees. We have reached certain hypercorrection of this lumbar arch, which later increased, but it still stayed at 0. These are the examples of the patients who initially had deformities of the parameters for surgical intervention by the patients. In the period of active growth, 10, 11, 12, 13, and even 14 years. And we have tried. Because not all the patients, not all the parents immediately give consent for the operation because they understand the risks. And we do not always initially we didn't indicate braces actively, but then we accumulated the experience and look what we received in the result, not only the process, especially the love example 71 degrees. This is the same patient who initially had 28. In a year we have in 4 years. He's been wearing the brace for 9 years, so we have 40 degrees. And we managed to maintain these degrees before the brace was cancelled. We have the full maturation of the spine. And we have 15 degrees after the cancellation. And these 15 degrees have been maintained for 25 years. This is a young guy who is 20 years of age now. And he is practically absolutely comfortable in his phoenix. He had to live as a small guy in the brace, with very strict brace. This is a clinical example of one of the patients that was published in the Surgery of the Spine magazine. That's how the patient looked before the brace and the picture shows after the therapy was finished. At 14, she entered our clinic with the classical 52 degrees of the thoracic lumbar arch. But we tried to use the growth plasticity and corrective mobility of the patient to use the brace method of therapy. In the course of 4 years, up to the age of 17 and a half, she was in a rigid brace. After the cancellation of brace, we had 15 degrees that have been maintained in the course of 4.5 years. Yes, the patients who have difficulties in the course of wearing the brace initially or in the process of treatment comes to the so-called surgical parameters over the angle of 40 degrees. We plan surgical interventions for these patients after the finish of the growth. And these options have been presented by Professor Mikhailovsky. In conclusion, we have defined clinical possibilities for brace therapy, namely the brace treatment in accordance with the junction or technology allows us to have significant three-plane correction and stabilization of the spine. Correction that may be stabilized later. How it will be stabilized with constant parameters with increase or decrease is very individual. The progression of the deformity may be effectively maintained in aggressive cases. And conclusion number three, when we have initially surgical parameters of the curvature, the brace treatment allows either to exclude the surgical intervention in the prepare the patient for the high-tech intervention for the period or by the period when the bone growth of the spine is finished. And I want to finish with this statement. In idiopathic sclerosis, to correct the deformities of the spine, therefore the bed and vertebrologists have to be a gardener in order to master the art of the 1930 года, который выступал в дискуссии, как надо оперировать больных с переломом. That such conservative treatment of scoliosis is useful. Well, we keep meeting with